So, what is factoring? Factoring is like the reverse of multiplying. Let's say I give you two numbers, 3 and 5, you can multiply them together to get the number 15. The reverse means that I give you the number 15 and you're asked for the factors to go back and work out that the factors are 3 and 5. And what's interesting is that all numbers, all natural numbers, can be written as a unique product of prime numbers, numbers that can be divided by only one and themselves. For instance, the number 42 can be written as the product of 2 times 3 times 7. Together, that gives 42. So why is factoring useful or relevant? It's useful because there is an important asymmetry in the complexity associated with multiplying versus factoring. Multiplying is easy and factoring is more complicated.
Let's have a look at the theory.
Let's take some examples. What are the factors of the number 91? If you think about it for a little bit, you'll realize, yes, indeed, it's 7 and 13. And you can quickly verify that indeed 7 times 13 gives back 91. But then, what are the factors of 2,372? That would take you much longer to figure out, certainly if you're trying to do it in your head. But what's interesting is that also computers require a time to factor numbers that quickly goes up with the length of the numbers, much more quickly than the time needed to multiply numbers. And this asymmetry is used in widely used cryptographic schemes. Schemes to protect secret information. For instance, if we would like to order a book over the internet and supply our credit card information, we wish that to be encrypted so that nobody else can intercept my credit card information. And that's done by using a secret key. In the factoring example, to create a key, we take two large prime numbers, which are easy to generate, and from there, compute the product. That, in essence, constitutes the key. Working back from the product to the prime numbers is very hard, and that's why this key is a safe key. Computer scientists actually distinguish in a quantitative way how complex different problems are. For the factoring case, the best classical algorithms require a time that goes up exponentially with the length of the number, from 15 to 91, 2,372. The time that it takes a classical algorithm to factor those numbers goes up as 2 to the power n, where n is the length of the number, an exponential complexity.
How can quantum solve this?
Shor's quantum factoring algorithm, on the other hand, requires a time that goes up only as n to the power 3. So not 2 to the power n, no, n to the power 3. That's a polynomial complexity, not an exponential complexity. And that's a big difference. It is essentially the difference between being able to solve this problem in a reasonable time versus not being able to solve the problem in a reasonable time at all. For instance, when we order a book and our credit card information is encrypted, the code used uses numbers long enough so that it would take the age of the universe to decipher this code, even on the most powerful supercomputers today. On a quantum computer, such encryption schemes could be broken in a reasonable time.
What are the caveats?
Now, some further comments are in order. First, building a quantum computer is really hard. It's actually one of the greatest challenges, scientific and technological challenges today. Second, the number of quantum bits that we require to factor realistic numbers is also very large. If we want to factor a number 200 bits, 2,000 bits long, it will take of the order of 10,000 quantum bits to do that. And that even assumes that those quantum bits are perfect. And in reality, we know that quantum bits are not perfect. To compensate for these imperfections, for these errors, we need to build in redundancy. And the redundancy is actually very significant. It's not a factor of 2 or 3. It can be a factor of 1,000, 10,000, bringing the total number of quantum bits that we need into the many millions. So, practically speaking, your messages will be safe for a while longer. But if you are concerned about the security of your messages, not just today, but also over 10 or 20 years, you really need to consider encryption schemes that even a quantum computer cannot crack.